Boyer and Newton going at it. Well, we'll show you why. Wow. And what happened after the checkered flag between these two. This is fun. This is all-star wrestling. All right. Wow. And unlike other all-star games, these fellas have to race each other every week of the season. Well, let's go back and see why the drama between Ryan Newman and Clint Boyer. This is on the cooldown lap after the checkered flag. Well, obviously, something took place before all this. Damn. But Boyer not Boyer at all. A machine. Which way? And there's trouble on Pit Row. Kyle Busch is down there. Kyle Busch is down there. I wish I had was proven. Let's show you what happened out on the track to precipitate this. Okay, now here's the wreck between these two from earlier this evening. Right there is Spencer. Spencer trying to get down under and look like John West came down now. Hard to tell from that angle how far. That's the lake there. It's a little hard to tell how far up under. So that's the most recent collection. And then this was a takedown there. We're going to get another takedown here. You get points for the takedown, right? You get two points for the takedown. And this is another, right? That's a takedown for Spencer. So 2-2. Yeah. Okay, that's the stake. And see how you can get the final point for blows landed. Yeah. It's 3-4-5. Yeah. Now the tired out part comes. Yeah. Hey, look at dancing right there. Daniel Suarez did not get the lap he won. He ends up 28, beating Michael McDowell, right on top of each other on the speed chart. And after round one of qualifying, Suarez went looking for McDowell to have a conversation. And Michael McDowell went after him. Punches were thrown. Crew chief attempting to break it up. Eventually, they did, and they had a conversation. What was that, Jenny?
Well, I'm joined by Michael McDowell right now. You saw me. He had a tone on, and it's almost like you knew that was coming. What happened on the track that led to the
qualification? No, I always have my helmet when I get in and out. It's an old habit. Just miscommunication on the racetrack. We all kind of waited till the end, and then he had a lot of traffic. So, just unfortunate. You know, he was upset. Got held up on his lap, and then he crashes, and I just didn't appreciate it. You guys talk about this before the race? Yeah, for sure. Just keep it on the stuff. It's racing. You know, it's short practice session, short qualifying. Getting late going to tech, and since you're in, so it's all part of it.
And with Daniel Suarez, what's your take on what happened there?
He's like, I respect. You know, I think he's making these races these days, and you have to qualify well to have a good solid B-roll and try to have a good second race. The race is long, so you don't know what's overcome that, but you just like respect. Everyone in the garage knows that second lap is a good one. You have to try to get out of the way if somebody's coming in the top lap. He didn't. He killed me in one corner. I had to go in the other way in the second corner. He didn't. No, I'm wrecking him then. And he wasn't pointing because I was trying to wreck
him after
the race. He had words and punches thrown. Now this was the aftermath. We're finally calm down and talk it over. And like you saw this build, the time's running out. They have less time this year than they ever had before in these rounds, and there's so many cars to get up the road. It's just a matter of time.